It's Beauty Junkie. Welcome to my channel. Today we are getting into the Auric Glow Lust Radiant Luminizer. I have the reformulated shade Morganite, which is the lightest shade they offer. I'm going to be getting into a demo. I'll do some swatches and natural lighting, and I'll be doing some comparisons to other glowy complexion products. I wanted to do natural lighting for this video because of the type of product this is. It's really difficult to see the color and shine in indoor lighting, and my lighting setup just isn't quite doing it for me with this product in particular. So things look a little bit different. So I will be trying this on in different ways, just barefaced, mixed in with foundation, and on top of foundation, because this product is designed to be mixed in, applied on its own, and as a highlighter, it does a lot of different things. So let's get into the product description. This is $45 for 35 milliliters, 1.18 ounces. You can get this at magicdusk.com, not Auric Cosmetics like you think it would be, but magicdusk.com, which I found to be a little bit strange. Unfortunately, at the time of this filming, this shade is sold out. All but three shades are sold out. So there was a recent restock. So I didn't, unfortunately, partake in the first launch of this. I think it was back in 2020, so I definitely missed out. And unfortunately, they only restocked the Glow Lust and not the cream and powder eyeshadow duos. I would have picked up one of those along with this, but they didn't. There's no stock in that. This seemed to sell out quickly again after the restock, and I didn't really know that there was going to be a restock. I'm not like on any email list. I just saw it on Instagram, and I think I bought it the night of the restock, like. So not right away. Anyways, I'm glad to finally get this, but unfortunately things are sold out again. So like keep an eye on Instagram, you know, subscribe to email newsletters, whatever you need to do if you guys really want to get this. I am surprised at the sturdy packaging. There's a glass bottle here. It has this pretty gold cap that comes off. And so this is a pump, which is really nice. The box, I think, is a little bit prettier than the bottle. It has this like marbling design on the front, which is so pretty. It's black and gold, has a really nice feature. I do like the gold cap, but I don't know. I wish there was maybe a little bit of marbling on here. Maybe just like marbling behind the gold name would have been nice. Just a nicer touch, but so this is $45. I think it is pricey, and you know, it is a pricey glow product, and I think that's because it was so new when it first came out and I wasn't sure if I was going to like it. I didn't want to commit to spending that much, but I think a lot of people have given this pretty positive reviews, so I partook in the restock. So all right, let's get into swatches. First, I'm going to swatch this on my wrist, and I have some b-roll of me like more directly in the sun, kind of shifting my wrist in the sun so you can kind of see it a little bit better, but I think you can see it pretty well on this light. It has like a kind of a platinum sheen. It's a very beige color, and this is a thicker product, to be honest, than I thought it was going to be. It's not super thick, but definitely thicker than some other liquidy glow products. And it's like beige in this light, but when you get in the sun, it has a more of a platinum silver shift. It's really gorgeous and kind of a lot more of an obvious glow than I thought. But you have to remember, like, this is like a concentrated swatch. When you put it, you know, all over your face or mixed in, it's not going to be as obvious. So you have some versatility with this product, and it is a really pretty sheen. And let's get into some comparisons. I don't have a ton of like glow products, but I came up with six glowy type of products. Some are liquid, Some are more of a balm form. Some of them are actually highlighters. So let's start with the Charlotte Tilbury, which a lot of you, I'm sure, are curious about. My labels weren't off. This is the Hollywood Flawless Filter in the lightest shade. Different applicator, but still glass packaging. And I'll try to go down here a little bit. This is obviously more of a golden tone, beige golden. And I would say a lighter formula, not quite as thick. So when I swatch these products, it's going to be really hard to differentiate between the Glow Lust and all the products because they start to kind of all blur into the same glowy type of situation. I kind of want you getting a sense of like color differences in case you guys are curious, and I'll try to explain some texture differences there. The next liquidy, glowy type of product that you can mix in with complexion products is the By Terry Brightening CC Serum. And I have the shade White Rose. I think it's also called another name, but it is the white shimmery version. There's other shades, but I just don't have them. That's way too much. This is a very liquidy, more sheer type of glow. And because it's so sheer, I think it mixes into lots of foundations easily. But you can definitely see how much of more of like a silver pearly tone that one is. So I just want to give you an idea of different textures. The last real liquidy product I have is the new Lisa Eldridge Elevated Glow. I have the shade Cosmic Rose. She does have four other shades. This texture reminds me a lot of the Charlotte Tilbury Hollywood Flawless Filter, except it's maybe a slightly different texture and a little bit more natural and sheer, but also kind of a beige tone. So I don't think I really have like a super good shade match dupe in my collection. This is an actual highlighter, liquid highlighter. This is the Charlotte Tilbury Hollywood Beauty Light Wand in Spotlight. The tone of this is kind of similar, but this is more of an intense highlight, not so much, whoops, that came out like crazy. This is not so much the same product, oh my goodness. But I think the tone is kind of close. This is a little bit more intense, a little bit darker beige, I suppose. I know it gets really tricky when we're comparing these two, but I think you can get the idea there. And then the last two I'm going to show you on this arm are more balmy type of products. This is the Westman Atelier Lit Up Stick in Nectar, a new shade that came out this year. This is way more sheer and a little bit more sticky. And you can just kind of see shine. Not a whole lot of color in my opinion. And then the last comparison I have is the Tom Ford Shine and Illuminate 0.5. And I'm gonna swatch this white balmy shade here, which I think has a little bit more obvious shine and glow than the Westman Atelier. It's just a little bit more silvery pearly. But those are the comparisons. Not like super easy to see. I don't really have anything similar, to be honest, in terms of texture and color in my collection. All right, I'm going to apply, starting with one pump here on just bare skin. I'm not even gonna put a primer. I have some sunscreen on, and this isn't the first time applying this, but I'm gonna just do with no primer just because it's a little bit thicker of a formula, a little bit more grippy. So I'm gonna put it all over. This is not normally something I would do, to be honest. I'm not like a glow first person. I will probably be more likely to mix this in my foundation or just put it on top of my makeup. as like a highlighter. But I know some of you will want to see what this looks like on bare skin. So that is one pump, and I think honestly that is probably enough. If I put more, it would probably get a little bit greasy looking. But it does have a really pretty glowy finish, and it's a little bit slit of a feeling. It's a very interesting product. It does give a really pretty glow. Like, if you don't like wearing makeup and just want to have a nice little added touch of sheen, this is beautiful. And I put it over sunscreen that's dried down for at least half an hour, and I didn't get any pilling or anything like that. If you do get pilling, I suggest putting on your skincare in layers more slowly. Let it dry down in between each layer and wait a good amount of time before you put on any makeup or primers to avoid that pilling effect, because sometimes things don't really attach to your skin that well, or it takes a little bit, and then you add more to it and you move it around. That's when you get those little balls of product. But I'm liking this glow. I think you can sort of tell a difference. But now I'm going to mix it in with foundation, and I'm going to be using the Surratt Dew Drop Foundation in shade number 3. A really nice coverage foundation that isn't super matte, so I feel like this would be a good candidate to mix this product with. Then I'll do one pump and mix it with my fingers. And then I'm going to apply on my face and use a foundation brush. I'm going to use the new Sonia G Classic Base Brush, which is a mix of goat hair and synthetic fibers. And I'm just going to start with this first and buff it in. Now, normally I would not do a base layer of a glow product and then mix it in and then put it on top, but I do want you guys to see what this product can do, because I think it does have some really good versatility. You just don't want to over apply. You don't want to have probably more than a pump on your face, maybe a pump and a half if you have a larger face than I do. Just because it can be a little bit too much glow. You've seen those people where like every product they use is shimmery and glowy, and it just makes you a little bit synthetic looking in my opinion, but I understand the temptation for sure. So these glowy type of products, sometimes they can enhance some of our more unflattering features such as texture, fine lines, and sometimes they can just bounce and deflect light in a really pretty way without covering up your skin in a thick layer of foundation. So it kind of depends. Can't really tell you which products are going to go one way or the other. I think it also depends a lot on your skin, the kind of makeup you're using with it. So when I first tried this, I didn't apply it in this natural sunlight. And I have to say, it's not super noticeable in indirect or indoor lighting, like at all. Like, yes, you can shift your face into the light and you can see that glow. But if you apply this with a heavier hand in the hopes that it will really show up and make you look super glowy, when you get into that real light, it's probably going to be too much. So just take a step back with this product. I still have a good amount of product left, but I feel like I don't need to put a lot more on, to be honest. So I'm just going to do a little bit of touching up. All right, so I applied this mixture, which I still have a lot left, but I feel like I don't really need that much more. I applied it with the brush, but I want to go back in with my damp sponge just because I want my pores to look a little bit smoothed out. And not that this doesn't look smoothing, but I just want an ultra like pushed in look. And I feel like I kind of over-applied, so I just want to also just remove some of the excess foundation and glow. And I think, honestly, this technique makes my makeup last longer by removing some of this extra product that's just kind of sitting on top. I honestly don't think I need concealer, but I think next time I probably would avoid putting it under here if you don't wear concealer under your eyes. Because I do think it kind of accentuates some of the finer lines. But if you're gonna put concealer on top, I don't think there's anything wrong with taking it all the way up under the eye. This is really pretty finish. I really like it with this foundation. I'm not sure how well this is going to do with every foundation. I did try this with the Shiseido Synchro Skin foundation and had a little bit more trouble in this area making things look smooth. I definitely needed to use a concealer, but this foundation is a little bit more dewy, so I think it worked better. I would have concerns applying this with a matte foundation, to be honest, just because it's a little bit tougher to move matte foundations around. So here's what it looks like. No powder, just the Glow Lust and Dewdrop foundation mixed in. Now let's try this just as a highlighter on my cheekbones. This, I just need a little bit, so I'm gonna apply this with my finger. And of course you're going to get the most concentrated, beautiful sort of platinum beige glow when you apply it, you know, directly in one spot as a highlighter. I would love to see like a powder formula in the shade. I think it's really pretty. I love a liquid highlighter, but sometimes I just want a powder to go with it. So you can see a little extra glow here. I mean, I'm a fan so far, if you can't tell. But let's get into the review of this product and what are my overall thoughts are. All right, guys, time for final thoughts. I just want you to up close see the texture of this product. It's thicker. It kind of feels like a balmy foundation almost. And you can see like concentrated, like it has some color behind it. It's not like some sheer, super barely there glow product. So it packs a good amount of punch. And for Morganite, it kind of has this like moonlight shift to it. It's like kind of silvery and it's there, but it's not there. Like when you move your face, you're going to see it, but it's like that wonderful lip from within glow that a lot of products try to achieve. It's almost like the Hourglass powders, the ambient lighting powders, how it has like that really subtle glowy effect. That isn't in your face. It's not like glittery, shimmery like that. I mean, this has more to it, obviously, than those, but same sort of idea, to be honest. Now, this is Morganite kind of blended out. You know, a little bit more, probably how much you would apply on your cheeks. And this is mixed in with the Surratt Dewdrop Foundation. So you can see, you know, it has that bit of like moonlight silver behind the foundation coming through. That makes it a little bit more subtle. Now, I obviously have like 3 layers of it on, so I probably have like really glowy skin right now. It is pretty, but for me, I worry about like later on in the day what this is going to look like. Am I going to be, like for me, I get an oily T-zone, not super oily, but it happens to all of us. I just get shiny. And when you have that glowiness with real shine, it can be a little bit much. Like if you have more of an oily skin type, you might want to just concentrate this product on certain areas and not necessarily all over your face or in your T-zone. So just think about that. You're applying this product, just you might want to be strategic, especially if you don't normally use glow products all over your face. I do think the effect is super pretty. Now, I did put on a loose powder on top of this just to create some longevity for my makeup. I use the Chantecaille loose powder in light. And that's all I use. I didn't put any concealer or anything else. And it looks great. I do think my nose is a little bit more textured looking. So I think you're gonna have to play with this, and it's going to change depending on the kind of foundation you mix this with. But I think it's a beautiful product on its own. But your skin type is going to have an influence. The makeup you use is going to have an influence. The skincare you put on before this is going to have an influence. The type of weather you live in is going to have an influence on what this is going to do for you. But I just want you to note that it's not this like super thin formula. So that might kind of affect how you might feel about it. But it is really pretty. Do I recommend it? Is it worth $45? Honestly, I don't know that I'm going to go through all of this very quickly at all, just because I'm not a person that mixes these kinds of products in my foundation that often. I appreciate a glow, but I like to be choosy where I put it just because of shine. I don't mind this. This is just definitely something very different for me. So I don't know that I'll be going through this like that often, and I'll just be pumping away. And if you're using it as a highlighter, you're going to use even less. So in that sense, I mean, this will last you a long time if you use it like how I plan to use it. But at the same time, because I use a lot of beauty products, I already have 6 other glowy products. It's not likely that I'm gonna finish this before it expires. And it's $45 while the formula is nice. Could I have used a smaller bottle? For sure. I mean, this is like a foundation size glow product, which I think out of all of these, this is the largest product. So it is, you know, good value for the money in that sense. But do we really need a full, like, foundation size of this? I'm not sure that we do. I don't think you can replace this as a foundation. Like, you can still see my pimples. You can still, even with mixed in with, you know, you're still going to need concealer if you have blemishes, redness, dark circles. It's not going to replace a foundation, which I think I kind of thought this would be a replacement for when I first learned about it, but then I realized, oh, it's not really that. But I think the amount of shine without makeup on this product is a little bit much for most people, especially if you are, you know, textured skin, aging skin. You can certainly rock it, but I think most of us are going to have a harder time putting this all over our face without makeup. So I would have been happy with a smaller bottle, to be honest, less cost. And I'm fine treating this more as a highlight with the option of mixing it in with my foundation rather than like all over glow by itself. I think that's a little bit too much. So I would have preferred a smaller bottle, less cost. I would have been fine with a plastic. I mean, I like the luxury feel of this, but you know, I don't think we had to have the luxury. Like, while the gold cap looks nice, this is like plastic on top and it feels a little bit light. But, you know, overall, I get what she was going for. It is pretty. I think it's, if you can get your hands on it, great. But I do think there are other glow options out there that you probably will enjoy. As far as, like, this unique shade, I don't know that it's, like, super, super unique. I think Spotlight was kind of close, kind of that beigey but silvery tint, and then the Hollywood Flawless Filter, somewhat close. These are a different texture, though. So I do think this is a cool product, but does it, like, totally blow my mind that I feel like you need to have it? Not really. If you're into it, if you like the tone of Morganite, certainly worth trying. Hopefully that was helpful. I know sometimes when I give my final thought, it may seem like I'm kind of wishy-washy because I like the product, but then at the same time, I'm like, there's so many other glow products out there. It's kind of hard to make anything unique these days. Those are my thoughts on the Auric Glow Lust. Let me know If you've tried this product, do you love it? How do you like to use it? And let me know what shade you have. Please comment below. If you like this video, click the thumbs up, subscribe, and I will see you all in the next one. Bye, guys.